With all this talk on the news about the need for a human vaccine for coronavirus, it's a reminder to those of us in the beef cattle industry that we need to do a good job with the vaccines that we use to protect our cattle. We want to remember the most effectiveness of the vaccine is going to be when we first purchase it. And it's our job to keep as much of that effectiveness as possible until we actually get it injected into the animal that is going to need that for disease protection. A good part of that is during the storage of vaccine to make sure that the facility that we store it in is set at the proper temperature. If you look on the label of most vaccines that we use in the cattle industry, it'll say to store these at 35 to 45 degrees Fahrenheit. You know, there was two studies done, one in Arkansas and one in Idaho, independent of each other, that went out to farms and ranches and actually checked the refrigerators that those folks were storing their vaccines in. In the case in Arkansas, only about 27% of the refrigerators that they checked stayed within that temperature range 95% of the time. It was a little better in Idaho, but not much. Only about 34% of the refrigerators that they checked stayed within that temperature range 95% of the time. That tells me that we want to really stay on top of what the temperature is in the refrigerator that we're using to store our vaccines in. Also, we want to remember that when we take that vaccine out to the working chute to work the cattle, that we want to make sure that vaccine stays at about that 35 to 45 degrees. A good way to do that is by doing a little engineering with a small ice chest that you can change to make sure that the syringes that you're using will fit down into that ice box and keep it cool until you're ready to actually inject it in the cattle. Also, look again at the SUNUP website and look for another excellent fact sheet. It's about the storage, the handling, the use of vaccines. It'll do a lot in terms of educating you about different things to do and don't do when you're handling these vaccines. We remember they're expensive to buy, and they're going to be even more expensive if they're not effective and our cattle come down with whatever disease we're actually trying to protect them with. Let's take a look at those two fact sheets. I think they'll go a long ways to helping you get the protection for your cattle that you want and need. Hey, we look forward to visiting with you again next week on SUNUP's Cow-Calf Corner.